yourself will take this part. Children.
Yes.
God bless you. Solana Priestley, Gisela Priestley, Michelina Priestley Gomes.
Yes. Happy holidays.
Thank you.
Happy holidays.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the prize.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. The psalmist said long time ago, bless the Lord, O my soul, and don't forget his benefits. It is he who heals all our diseases. Bless the Lord, O my soul. This is Reverend Dr. Gomes from the Riverside Church in downtown Wareham, and have a blessed new year in the year 2013. And not only that, but also I have a lesson for you to press on in 2013. And the text for this lesson for this new year to press on in 2013 is taken from the epistle of the book of Philippians, where the Apostle Paul writes in the third chapter, beginning at verses 12 and verse 14. Listen to Paul, how he presses on. Not as though I have already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I'm apprehended of Jesus Christ. Paul goes on to say in verse 13, brothers and sisters, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth for those things which are before. And I press toward the mark of the prize of the high. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. Brother Paul, press on. Not that I've already attained, Paul is saying. Press on. Not that I am perfect. Press on. That I may lay hold to which Christ Jesus has also laid hold on me. So press on in 2013. How am I going to do that? Forget what lies in the past. Press on, Paul is saying. Straining forward to what lies ahead. Press on. I press on toward the goal. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call. Press on. The upward call of God in Christ Jesus. During this time of the year, there are a number of ways we reflect upon the new year. There are rituals that we witness, whether we travel to Times Square in New York City or sit home warm and safe in our family rooms and watch this ritual. There's another ritual, one in the church. Both well attended. I can remember many of the churches that I've served, one in particular in Taunton, where Massachusetts, where they called it Watch Night. Have you been there? Or has your church done that, something called Watch Night on New Year's Eve? I know many of you have. Pray prayers, sing songs, recall blessings, and resolve to press on. Perhaps you also participated in that other American ritual, the secular one I told you about in New York. It's different. If it's not New York, maybe there's another way that you reflect on the new year. I know some, my friends, and I too, when I was younger, this is how I celebrated the new year. Get as many together in one place, have as much noise as possible, drink as much as you can, have a good time, and make resolutions that we forget the next day. Press on, though, Paul is telling us. Press on without fear. Here's a reflection. Another thing that religious people do, why do they do this? Scripture insight causes them, perhaps, or sections of Scripture that people know, pick and choose. Why are so many so obsessed with the end of the age? There's this sense of paranoia that is in the air sometimes in spiritual circles. There's a sense of gloom. There's a sense of doom. They claim the second coming is near. Despite the warnings of Jesus saying, no man knows the time or the day when the Father comes. I'd rather just be prepared, like Jesus says. Not worrying about doom or gloom or the end of the ages. I'm not worried about it at all. I'm just being prepared. How about you? I'm looking for the year 2013 as a year of blessings. How about you? Press on in 2013 without fear. Press on. What is it about the future that makes both believers and unbelievers so frightened and driven? They're driven more by fear than they're driven by faith. Let's press on with faith. As we read the Apostle Paul, if you had the Boston Globe or another magazine or newspaper in front of you, or after watching the TV news or surfing through the internet, it's a breath there to listen to Paul, the great apostle, who writes to the Philippians and to us. Paul is not afraid of the future. Paul is not intimidated, but he boldly proclaims, not that I have it all, not that I've attained everything, not that I'm perfect. One thing about the Apostle Paul, he sure preaches plain and honest, but I press on that I may lay hold to that for which Christ Jesus has laid hold of me. There's no fear in that. Forget what lies behind. Well, I know we can look to the past, and if the past preoccupies us with doom and gloom and depresses us, the Apostle Paul is telling us to wake up. Forget what lies behind. And I know that's not easy, but with prayer, good counseling, spiritual and psychological, seek the experts. They'll help you. I'm saying forgetting what lies behind is not as easy, but with a good counselor and good direction and with God's guidance, we can do it. You see, Paul says it's a straining. It's not. There's an effort there. It's a straining toward what lies ahead. Even this idea of pressing on.
there's a sense of pressure and straining. Press on toward the goal, but it's a goal that's worthy. It's a goal for a prize of an upward call. That upward call is God in Christ Jesus. Press on with your own self this year in 2013. A good friend of mine and a professor at a divinity school in Cambridge, who is no longer with us now, but some of my audience love to listen to him. He had the same last name as mine. The only thing difference, he was known around the world. I'm known on my street. But this good, I'll call him Professor Peter. He says the Apostle Paul was the type of a man that had an attitude without an apology. He had an attitude without an apology. And Professor Peter and Preacher Peter, he says, if you want credentials, I've got them. He's talking about Paul. Paul's saying, I'm pressing on. If you want to know who I am and what my credentials are on, I want you to know I've got credentials and I've got confidence in the flesh. I have more than all of the religious leaders in town. Paul would have said through the words of Professor Peter, I've got credentials more than the Greeks, more than the Romans, more than the Christians, and I'm proud of it, so don't mess with me. You remember Peter? You think you have achievements? Paul would say, I have more. I'm from the tribe of Judah, Benjamin. I am a Jew, and I'm proud of it. A1, number one. And you can't outfox me with all your genealogies. I got that too. As to the law, I'm a Pharisee. I'm a super ecclesiastic lawyer. I'm a Harvard Law School graduate. Don't mess with me. As to zeal, man, I was a persecutor of the church. Are you kidding me? If I kept going, there might have been no church at all. I can see Peter now. He'll say, there'll be no church at all. As to righteousness, I'm blameless. That's what Paul would say. You can't find any fault in me. An apostle with an attitude without any apologies. Press on with Christ in 2013. All of this he has. All of this he counts, the Apostle Paul, as a loss. All of this, Paul says, it's like rubbish. It's like junk comparison to what he has in Christ Jesus. All of those credentials that Paul mentioned. He says, in a sense, I'm taking my credentials and my past, and I come to Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Getting back to Professor Peter, he would put it this way. This is the man who met Jesus on the Damascus Road. This is the man who was thrown from his ride on his backside. This is the man who had more escapes than Houdini and all the assistants with God. And this is the man who preached to the high and the low. And this is the man who was not afraid of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Yeah, this is the man who preached Christ and him crucified. And this is the man who admonishes us today to press on in the year 2013. I said earlier, it's not easy to forget the past. Forgetting what lies behind and strain toward what lies ahead, I press on. Paul instructs, your best days are ahead of you. I remember reading about Bishop Desmond Tutu, the chair of Truth and Reconciliation in South Africa, wrote words about the past. Those of you who know Desmond Tutu, he grew up in the period of apartheid. Talk about the past. And all the fury that was exerted upon his people. How can you forget that? Listen what he says. The delicate balance between truth and things it reveals. And the effort to reconcile means going beyond truth. It was one of the most difficult things, Desmond Tutu says. It's hard to let grudges go. I mean, here's a man that understood more than grudges, being brought up in apartheid system. He says it's hard to let them go, the grudges. It's hard to let the memories of grievance. He says it's grievance is greater than the grudge. It's hard to let that go. He goes on to write. Yet we must forget the past. We must forget the past and look to what lies ahead and strain forward to Christ Jesus and press on. Forgive and forget is what a lesson he leaves us. The reason we confess our sins is that the remembrance of sin is grievous. That's why we confess it. The burden of sin is intolerable to have it in us. The only way to free oneself is to forget what lies in the past. You'll find a new day when you're able to do that. May the Lord bless you with that value this year, to be able to forgive and to forget. Number two, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. This is more, Paul is thinking, no doubt, metaphorically of a runner. A runner can't afford to look back. You see, a runner has to strain. She has to strain toward the goal. And if she doesn't use her feet when she's straining toward the goal. She's using her whole body. She's using her head and her neck. She's stretching toward that mark or the future, and it helps carry the feet forward. That's the posture of 2013. The goal for Paul is the upward call for God in Christ Jesus. The upward call. The upward call is something that moves one forward to the goal. One is literally fueled to the goal. This is the point to recognize for the new year. What we seek is in front of us, not behind us. It's not beside us. It's in front of us. That is where it is. Keep it there. Keep your mind focused on your goal. This is how we find it. It's the future, and no other place will do. Press on. If you're in high school, you have a goal, press on. You're in intermediate schools, you have a goal, and press on. You're looking for a job this year, have a goal, and press on. Strain, work toward it. What does it mean for you and me to press on in 2013? In conclusion, don't be discouraged. Don't be intimidated. Don't be taken in. Don't be diverted. Be like Paul. I've got credentials. I believe in myself. And I believe in the Lord God Almighty is going to help me this year to do a better thing in 2013 than I ever did in 2012. This is the way to do it. Forgetting what lies in the past and straining toward the future. Press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. What are you carrying into the new year that hinders you? What's tripping you up? What's tipping your balance? What is the burden? Is it an old grudge? Is it some bad news? Is it unfinished business? Is it something unsettled? Some things we have to just settle by action, by doing something positive about it. Go to God in prayer. Get some good counsel. Find some good advice. Find a good church. And put down those things in the past. Let them go. Drop them. Forget about it. In Christ, your best days are ahead of you. In Christ, you can try again. In Christ, you can strain toward what lies in the future. In Christ, you can press on, press on, press on to that upward call. Not that I've already obtained it. Not that I've made perfect, but I know I can press on. I'm a work in progress. I'm not what I should be. And I'm not where I ought to be. But thank God Almighty, since I've been converted, I'm not what I used to be. The prize of the upward call. Are you looking for a church? Are you looking to find a place to help you on your spiritual journey? Come to the Riverside in 2013. But this, remember this. Have a blessed and a happy new year. May the good Lord watch over you, bless you, keep you, help you out in every way. God bless you. Dr. Gomes at the Riverside, downtown Wareham.
Bless the Lord.